I'm done with the whole Ghana city summit, and I think it was very interesting in there. Yeah. What do you think about it?
Well, I think it's a positive step that has been taken by the Directors Guild. I pray and hope that from there we'll reach the foundation and then continue.
So what is the main reason? What is the actual call that is making Ghana movies not seen like it's not taken seriously? It's taking anyhow, people take it for granted, it's not ending and all that. What is the main cause for that?
I think policies are not working. If policies are in place, we should have a viable movie industry working. Not losing sight of the fact that all the cinema houses have been turned into churches and other things. This thing started when videos started coming to people's homes. So I think in all, we need a new branding, a rebranding like it's been started now. Maybe from here, we'll have a way forward.
And also from my point of view, I think producers don't take actors and new actors very seriously.
New actors, no. Actors in general.
Thank you. Seriously.
Because that was what I said, policies don't work. If policies will work, yes, things will change. Will you believe that for years, it's now that ASOC, Association of Screen Actors, and has been brought to the notice of some of the actors that yes, we need to get some royalties from ASOC, which we didn't know from the beginning. And these producers were all along business taking us for granted. So like you're saying, it's also true, it's perfect. But I hope we go to one then to continue.
So it's high time we say enough of all the lies. If they want us to work for us, for them, they should pay us, no matter what it is.
Yes.
Because people see us to be very rich.
Yes.
Very
yes.
rich. But it's just legendary actors, great other than a whole lot, about improving the industry. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I think it's very necessary at these times because we need film to develop our nation. Relying on film to develop our nation cannot be overemphasized because it's very, very necessary. And pulling all stakeholders together to make sure this happens is also very necessary. The government thinking about making policies to improve this is very necessary. This becoming a national conversation is also necessary. So today is very, very necessary in the history of filmmaking in this country. So I appreciate the organizers for putting it together. I appreciate the Office of the First Lady for also being a part of it. And the stakeholders like the Film Producers Association, the Ghana Actors Guild, the film directors, guild, all of them coming together to make this happen, it's very, very important.
Okay, so what do you think has really gone wrong in the industry that needs to be like really boosted up very, very seriously? Like, we should tackle on that.
Yeah, because we have not paid attention to it. We have not considered it as one of the main areas that can help in employment to bring money to the state. We have not looked at all these angles of film in this country. And that is very, very poor because mighty states like America, India, and a lot of other countries have made a lot of impact on the world through their films. So if we are sitting by and ours is retrogressing, that is not brilliant enough. And it's important that we recover and get back on the right track.
And you know that a lot of people don't say that I'm doing movie for fun, I'm doing because it's my leisure time and a whole lot. And a lot of people say the movie is not paying enough. Don't you think because of these two reasons, a lot of people don't take movies seriously?
Yes, because there are no policies to account for your production cost when you put in your money. Because when you are producing now, you don't know where you're going to make your money from. Because there are no cinemas to show your film. There are no proper lay down structures so that even the new media, social media, and all of the other media that's giving out our projects to bring financial returns to the producers, the actors, and everybody. TV stations are one. You can see them showing extensive foreign content. And the sponsorship that comes from this foreign content, obviously they are paying for the programs, then it means the money is going to the producers and directors of this country. What are the TV stations doing to empower local producers to turn in good shows? If the TV stations will accumulate all those sponsorships that they have for this foreign content, and spend it on local content. It could make a huge difference. So there are a lot of things that are supposed to be said, there are a lot of things that are supposed to be done for us to progress in terms of filmmaking. But they are very, very necessary.
And since growing up, it's been old face from the one I know. It's been, so what happened to the new artists? Is that they're not doing much, or they are not ready to learn, or you have the producers are refusing to introduce them?
Yes, capacity building is very, very important. In the structures, we should find ways we are going to train world-class actors and world-class directors and work. Kwame Nkrumah took directors from this country and sent them out to India to learn. So we are not developing the capacities. You know, how many film schools or drama schools do we have? And do they even find it attractive after school to get into the industry? These are questions that we need to be asking. You see, it's a general situation. It's not one area or the other. It's a matter of us having a detailed plan, carefully done, you know, to take us forward. So it wouldn't be just one area of actors not being interested. They are not getting there because they don't make anything out of it.
Definitely.
Elsewhere, artists are very rich.
Yeah.
Here, they are very poor.
Very.
So how are we going to marry?